Good morning students, welcome to the YouTube channel of Gyanmanjari Modern School. Myself Rachna Shukla and we are here with the last topic of our chapter, that is our ongoing lesson number 3, squares and square root. So today we will solve some of the problem sums of exercise 3D. So let's solve that. See, I am reading question number 5A from your textbook, and that is the length of each side of a square field is 63 meter. What is the area of the field? Starting with the first one, question number 5A, the question is one square field is there and the sides of the square field is 63 meter. And students, all of you know that in a square all the sides are same. In a square all the sides are same. So 63 63 63 and 63. Now you have to find the area. Area means the inner portion of the square field in this sum. So your question, your answer will start like this way: side of the square field is equal to 63 meter. Yes, side of the square field is equal to 63 meter. So area of the square field is equal to side into side, and that is side square. What is the formula to find area? The formula to find area of the square field is side into side, and that is side square. So we will write 63 square, and that is 63 into 63. So calculate 63 into 63 and write down your answer, and that will be in meter square. What will be your answer? Because side is in meter, so area is meter square. Meter, 63 meter into 63 meter will be, the answer will be meter square. Remember students, your perimeter answer is always in meter or centimeter, and the area answer is always in meter square or centimeter square. So this way you will calculate your 5A. Once again I repeat, there is one square field. The side of the field is 63 meter, it is given. So in a square all the sides are same. So if you want to find out the area of the square field, you will use the formula of area of the square, and that is side into side, as it is written here, that is side square. So you will write 63 square, that is 63 into 63. So you will get the answer in meter square. That will be your answer. Now let's do the second sum. Question 5B. So first I am reading it. A square room of side 12 meter is to be paved with square tiles of side 50 centimeter. What is the number of the tiles required to pave the floor of the room? So let's understand the question first. Students, copy this sum in your fair book. You have to copy this in your fair book. Your next question, 5B. See, there is a square room. A room is there. First, drawing the figure. There is a square room, and the side of the square room is given, and that is 12 meter. So what is the sides of the room? 12 meter. All the four sides of 12 meter. Now in this room tiles are to be paved. दैट मीन्स द फ्लोरिंग इज टू बी डन, टाइल्स आर टू बी पेव्ड. सी लाइक दिस वे, स्मॉल स्मॉल टाइल्स आर टू बी पेव्ड. Like this way in the whole box, that is the whole room, small tiles of the size square is to be paved, and the size of the tiles is 50 centimeter. What is the side? 50 centimeter. So all the sides of the tiles will be 50 centimeter, 50, 50 and 50 centimeter. So first convert 50 centimeter into meter. You have to convert it into meter. So let's start solving the sum. Your first step is side of the square room. Yes, side of the square room. This is the room that is 12 meter. First, right? 12 meter, your side. Now, finding out the area. Area of the square room is equal to side into side. So first you will find out the area of the room, that is this area, the whole area. So it will be side into side, and that is 12 meter into 12 meter. It will be 144 meter square. What will be your answer? You will get 12 square as 144 meter square. Now what to do? Now you have to find out the area of one tile. What you have to find? The area of the tile. So area of tile, you have to find this. So for that, you will first write side of the square tile. What is the one side of the square tile? It is 50 centimeter. Here it is centimeter, here it was meter. So if you want to convert centimeter into meter, you will write down 50 centimeter. Therefore 50 upon 100, because 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. So 50 upon 100 is 0.5 meter. What will be the side of the square tile in terms of meter? It will be 0.5 meter. How? 50 centimeter, so 50 upon 100, that is 0.5 meter. Now, area of the square tile. Area. So again side into side, and that is 0.5 meter into 0.5 meter. What will be 0.5 meter into 0.5 meter? It will be 0.25 meter. 0.25 meter square. Yes, we have got two answers. That is, the first one is area of square room, that is 144 meter square, and the area of one tile, that is 0.25 meter square. Now you have to find out the number of tiles required for this much area. You have to find out the number of tiles required. So I am writing here, students, number of tiles required is equal to area of room, area of room upon area of tiles. So what will be the number of tiles required? The formula is area of room divided by area of tiles, that is area, this area divided by this area. So let's calculate and find out what will be your answer. 144 upon 0.25. so calculate this and find out your answer. That will be your answer, that will be the number of tiles required by this room. So you have to divide this 144 divided by 0.25 and write your answer in the box. That solution you will find out by yourself. Please note down the sum in your fair book. Now we will start the next sum, that is question 5C. And I am reading the question from the book. Question 5C. The perimeter of a square plot of land is 64 meter. What is the area of the plot? So, perimeter of the square plot is given. First, let's draw the figure. A square plot, and perimeter is given. Perimeter means the total of all four sides. All the four sides total is perimeter. So your question will answer will be perimeter of a square plot is equal to 64 meter. What will be the answer? 64 meter. Now you have to find out the area of the plot. So first we will find out the side of the square plot. Therefore, side of the plot is equal to, what will be the side of the plot? Is equal to perimeter upon 4, perimeter divided by 4, and that is 64 upon 4. That will be, divide 64 by 4, 16. It will be 16. Your answer will be 16 meter. What will be the side, one side of the plot? That will be 16 meter. See, 16 meter on all the four sides. So it will be 64 meter perimeter. Now talking about area, area of the square plot, and the formula of the area of the square is side into side, that is side square. So 16 square, what is the side we got? We got 16. 16 square is equal to 16 into 16. So what will be 16 into 16, students? Find out and write down your answer in meter square. You will find out 16 square and write down the area of the square plot in meter square. Okay, students? Understood? Now let's try another sum, a problem sum. Note down this sum. The next question, question 5D. Question number 5D. So I am reading the question from the book. Question 5D, find the length of the hypotenuse of a right angle triangle whose other sides are 12 meter and 5 meter. So one right angle triangle is given like this way. Okay, and two sides are given here. The right angle triangle, two sides are given. This is 12 meter and this is 5 meter. You have to find out the hypotenuse. And let's name the triangle as A, B, right angle, and C. We have named the triangle by ourselves. So if we want to find out the hypotenuse, that is the third side in this triangle ABC. AB is 12 meter, it is given in your question. BC is 5 meter, it is also given in your question. Now let's start solving. So AC, by Pythagoras theorem, we have already studied what is Pythagoras theorem in your 7th standard. So by Pythagoras theorem, AC square is equal to, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So this is the formula that is given by Pythagoras. According to Pythagoras theorem, AC square, that is hypotenuse square, is equal to AB square, that is height square, plus BC square, base square. This is called base, this is called height, and this is called hypotenuse. So let's start solving the sum. AC square is equal to AB square. What is AB? AB is 12. 12 square plus BC square. What is BC? It's 5. Okay, students, now what is 12 square? It's 144. Plus what is 5 square? It's 25. 5 5s are 25. Now add both these things. 144 plus 25 is 169. AC square is 169, but we have to find out AC, not AC square. Here we got AC square as 169. So if you want to find out AC, AC is equal to root 169. Root 169, because this square, if we want to remove the square, we will put here root. That is 169 root is 13 meter. So we got AC as 13 meter. So 13 is your answer, students. 13 meter is AC. Please note down the sum. With this, student, we have completed our chapter number 3. We have completed exercise 3D and we have seen many problem sums related to squares and square root. I have completed lesson number 3, squares and square root. You have to complete your example book up to date. That is lesson number 1, 2, 3 and your fair book lesson number 1, 2 and 3. So all the examples you will write in your example book. All the exercise work you will write in your fair book. Like this way you will maintain your 2 books for maths. No other books. Only 2 books for maths. And that is one example book, writing all the examples, and one exercise book or fair book for writing the exercise sums. And now I will explain you how to do exercise 3D. In exercise 3D, your question 1, you have to make one correction in that. The question is, find the square root of the following numbers by division method. It is written as by division method. So cancel division method and there write down by prime factorization method. what you have to write down? By prime factorization method. No division method, students. By prime factorization method in question number 1. Make this correction in your book. Then question number 2. In question number 1, you will do the LCM method and you will find out the square root by prime factorization method, no division method. Next, find the square root of the following rational numbers. That is, the rational numbers are given 4 upon 9, 16 upon 25, 9 upon 16. You will find out the square root by prime factorization method, both different LCM and then finding the square root. So by this method you will solve question 1 and 2. The third one you don't have to do. Fourth one also no need to do, students. Third, fourth are cancelled. Question number 5 I have already taught you in this video. Question number 5, A, B, C and D. Only 4 sums. Then question number 6, no need to do. And now with this we have completed our lesson and exercise 3D. So question 1 and 2. So today's homework, exercise 3D, question number 1, 2 and in 5, A, B, C and D in your fair book. Where you have to do? You have to do in your fair book. Question number 1, 2 and in 5, A, B, C, D. So this much sums you will do in your fair book, and by this time you have to complete your example book and fair book of lesson number 1, 2 and 3. You will be asked at any time for your book checking. You have to submit your both books for your book checking as a part of your internal marks. So please, students, complete your work timely and submit your book. Till then, we will meet in the next part, starting with the next lesson. Till then, thank you and bye-bye. Take care.